sisters, may the Lord be
with you.
As we begin our second week of Advent, we place our lives at the Lord's altar. Let us humbly ask now for forgiveness of our sins.
Lord Jesus, you are the promised Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are the promised Wonderful Counselor. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the promised Messiah. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and lead us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, may no earthly undertaking hinder those who set out in haste to meet your Son. But may our learning of heavenly wisdom gain us admittance to his company, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Comfort. Give comfort to my people, says your God. Speak tenderly to Jerusalem and proclaim to her that her service is at an end, her guilt is expiated. Indeed, she has received from the hand of the Lord double for all of her sins. A voice cries out, in the desert, prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight in the wasteland a highway for our God. Every valley shall be filled in, every mountain and hill shall be made low, the rugged land shall be made a plain, the rough country a broad valley. Then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all people shall see it together, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken. Go up onto a high mountain, Zion, herald of glad tidings. Cry out at the top of your voice, Jerusalem, herald of good news. Fear not to cry out and say to the cities of Judah, here is your God. Here comes with power the Lord God who rules by his strong arm. Here is his reward with him, his recompense before him. Like a shepherd, he feeds his flock. In his arms, he gathers the lambs, carrying them in his bosom and leading the ewes with care. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
St. Peter. Do not ignore this one fact, beloved, that with the Lord one day is like 1,000 years, and 1,000 years like one day. The Lord does not delay his promise, as some regard delay, but he is patient with you, not wishing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. But the day of the Lord will come like a thief, and then the heavens will pass away with a mighty roar, and the elements will be dissolved by fire, and the earth and everything done on it will be found out. Since everything is to be dissolved in this way, what sort of person ought you to be, conducting yourselves in holiness and devotion, waiting for and hastening the coming of the day of God, because of which the heavens will be dissolved in flames and the elements melted by fire? But according to his promise, we await new heavens and a new earth in which righteousness dwells. Therefore, beloved, since you await these things, be eager to be found without spot or blemish before him, at peace. The word of the Lord.
"You don't have to be afraid of the dark, Johnny," she said.
Jesus is always there. He'll protect you. Little Johnny looked at his mother and asked, "Are you sure Jesus is out there?" "Yes, I'm sure," she said. "He's everywhere, and he's always ready to help you when you need him." Little Johnny thought about it for a moment, went to the back door, cracked it open just a little, and peering out into the darkness, he called, "Jesus, would you please hand me the broom?" Last weekend, when Deacon Steve was reading the gospel, we heard the very last word, and that was the theme of last weekend's homily. It was watch, meaning that we need to be ready, that we need to be alert, that we need to be prepared, because something great is coming. That we always do that during this great season of Advent, that we're preparing ourselves to welcome the birth of the Lord as we celebrate Christmas again, as we ready ourselves for the very second coming of Christ. We need to be ready. We need to be willing. We need to be active disciples, and not just those who might believe and say, "Yeah, I'm a Christian," but you wouldn't know it by what they do, by the way they act, by the way that they think. We all need to be able to be watchful for a great day that's coming. So that sets the theme, truly, of what needs to happen as we get closer to Christmas. And that is, of course, today's theme for the whole week, that we must be filled with hope. That hope that just realizes that something truly will happen to us, that will change us or change the world in just a little bit of difference in order for us to recognize and appreciate. Do you realize that most of us pray when it's dark outside? There's a greater sense that not only that there is something greater than us out there, but we are more tuned in with who we are when we're alone. So our scripture reading for this week in the Advent presents us with a pretty simple focus as well. It screams out to us to be hopeful. In our stillness, our darkness, in our prayers, we know that our God hears us, that Jesus is present, always, here with us. He will hand us that broom and whatever we truly need. Our first reading from Isaiah gives us reassurance that the message from God is that of comfort. He will make the mountains lower. He will raise the valleys in order for our path to him to be made level, to be made easier in order for us to get to him. We must agree that if we are with him, then it means that we are in the promised land. We're hopeful to get there. Yet, if we really are with him, we already see what the promised land is, because we're with him. We must not lose focus on who he is. He's not the promised land. He is God. And we must not only be thankful, but we must worship him. So many people get confused at this one point. We are always blessed by God, but we don't take the place of God. We need him, always and forever. Those who have no dependency on God fall down the slippery slope of self-destruction. Think about it. When societies don't want God in their lives anymore, they crumble. They fall apart. The presence of God is yearning us to get closer to him. And we do that. And that's what a beautiful season of Advent is all about. That we yearn to be closer to the very presence of God in our lives. So, the question comes about, the theme is hope. What are we hoping for? And that may be different for each one of us here this afternoon. But in this season of Advent, when we get closer to God and we know his presence among us, what is it that we're hoping for? What is it that we're wanting to be just a little bit different in our world today? Hope is more than optimism. Hope endures even in impossible situations. Can you see Jesus everywhere? Can you see him even in the consecrated bread and wine? You are about to receive him in the Eucharist, whether here in our church or in your hearts at home. My brothers and sisters, receive him. Be a hope-filled people. Yes, he is here with us now, and yes, he will be with us until the end of time. So, again, be hopeful. Now pray together in the confession of faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, whom all things were made, for us man and for our salvation, and down to heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our Savior was crucified on Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Lord, you give us comfort and peace to your people. We come before you with prayers of our hearts.
For our Holy Father, Pope Francis, and all bishops and priests, that they will shepherd the church with wisdom and loving compassion, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For civil servants and government officials, that they will provide comfort to those who seek assistance, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all expectant parents anxious for a new child, or those who hold vigil with loved ones facing death, that they find peace after hope-filled waiting, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For members of our community, especially those who are unable to be with us today, that they may faithfully await new heavens and a new earth, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
that we may prepare for the new heaven and new earth by fostering respect and protection for all human life, including the unborn. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let those responsible for public safety, especially firefighters, law enforcement, and military personnel, come home safely to their families. Let us pray to the
Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
For the deceased members of the Tiff family, for which this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick of our parish and of our families, and for the unspoken prayers, deep in the silence of our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, of goodness and grace, may we heed Isaiah's message as we strive to prayerfully prepare for the way of the Lord. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts of the powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. Time that he was betrayed, and entered willingly into his passion, took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood of the new and eternal covenant, which be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
And we eat this bread and drink this cup. We proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer the Lord the bread of life and the chalice of salvation. Giving thanks, you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Peter, our Bishop, with all the clergy and religious, and all who serve your church. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace and the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, St. Joseph, our beloved spouse, the blessed apostles, St. Rose of Lima, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs of eternal life, may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. With the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of Jesus, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not in our sins, but in the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever." Amen. May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
Of the world, and we will see.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy you should enter into my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be cleansed. Body and blood of Christ, keep us safe for eternal life. Body of Christ.
Amen.
The blood of Christ.
Amen.
Any visitors or guests that are here this evening, from this point forward, Mass be a little different than you're used to. In a couple of minutes, I'll be doing the closing prayer and the closing rites, which will end our Mass, after which Deacon Steve and myself will purify our hands and place our Mass on, then offer you the Eucharist. You're welcome to come up to the center aisle, and the last blue line, take off your mask, and that way there we can give you the Eucharist. We like doing two things at one time. Once you receive the Eucharist, simply place the mask back on. You're welcome to stay and pray as long as you want, or you're welcome to go and journey forth. But just ask you to see, I can't really see too much outside. Please be careful going down the stairs and into the parking lot. I'm not sure what the conditions are out there, but it looks like it's okay. So let us stand for our closing prayer. Let us pray. Replenished by the food of spiritual nourishment, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, that through our partaking in this mystery, you may teach us to judge wisely the things of earth and hold firm to the things of heaven, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, may the Lord be with you.
Amen.
May God bless you in the name of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Let us go in the peace and joy of Christ.
Thanks be to God. Have a nice week.
Thank you.